I feel nauseous, believe me. Never had a lot of shit come easy. Had to work hard, struggle just to be me.
At your service. This axe just keeps getting stronger.
Well, I'll be in my room.
Boy, I'm glad this axe is in your hands. Fire's actually a disinfectant, so these are very hygienic. Always a joy to work on these. They'll get your point. The Lady of the Forge has done it again. The Lady forges, and we perfect. So sharp, they won't even feel it, mostly.
Freya, you mentioned that Fimbulwinter had worn down some of Odin's curses, but you still needed help. Was it Sigrun who helped you recover your warrior spirit?
Is that how Odin liked to refer to the curse that kept me from defending myself?
Oh, I suppose that is where I heard it.
Would you like to know how that curse really worked? What it did to me? What it cost me to finally break it?
I'm no longer sure that I do.
That's correct.
Well, Sigrun must have helped find your Valkyrie wings. Were they hidden in the place I guessed?
They were not. But yes, she did. Argued all the while I should let my anger go, but helped me just the same. Let's find your wolves. Get back to tracking the Norns. Something you need to do before we find the Norns? What is this path?
Oh, just one of the many insane things we had to do to get to Jotunheim.
You jumped?
We were protected.
Evidently.
Enough. I remember.
If you're ready to find the Norns, let's get back to your sled.
This thread of fate we are tracing.
It's not somebody's life, if that's what you mean. The Norns use it to mark their way when they're outside of the well.
The Norns live in a well.
No. The Well of Urd, their home, is hard to explain. It's in no fixed place. Entrances come and go. A place wholly under their influence. Where the intangible becomes tangible. Like being inside your own mind.
But if we go in together, are we in each other's minds? Not so sure I like the sound of that.
How strange. I've never seen that building before.
Aye. Very strange indeed. Let's take a closer look.
Nasty hit! All right, brother! Right side!
That's blocking the entrance. It looks exactly like the one from Tyr's statue.
Brother, your fight with Thor must have scattered pieces of Tyr's statue all over the lake. Looks like the shield ended up lodged here. All this must have been hidden behind the ice until that shield smashed through it.
Something inside, but we can't reach it with the shield, can we? Doesn't look like you can brute force it.
Could be useful.
done. Now we just need to open the gate. Well done.
Intentional.
Oh, sure. My arrows can't go through walls, I'm afraid. Together again. You won't believe it, Mimir. This crest belongs to Fjotrlund.
Fjotrlund, you say? Now that's where Sigrun was from.
The vault is locked, of course.
Then we should find the keys.
That's the spirit, brother. Not personally. Freya's right. They have ways of discouraging visitation. Odin made his share of efforts. Wouldn't talk about what he found. Either he gave up, or he wanted to forget what he saw. Freya, you mind telling us what you experienced when you sought the Norns last time?
To be honest, the details are hazy. Like waking up from a dream. Mainly, I remember that nothing could be done to change my son's fate. Which only made me more determined to try. This way won't get you to the Norns, to be clear.
Brother, what of your story? You faced the fates of your homeland, yeah? The legends I heard about the ghost of Sparta were surely exaggerated.
Exaggerated?
Oh, not in the brazen bloodshed Righteous Fury part. The part where it said you traveled back in time itself to win a battle once lost. It's strange credulity, obviously. I mean, a rumor about Thor knocking the world serpent back in history from Ragnarok is one thing.
It is the truth. The threads of fate span all life and time.
Brother, seems the wolves have led us here.
I feel something. In this direction.
Feel what exactly?
Another illusion. It's coming from this wall. The Norns are hiding something. Opna. Nothing. Another dead end.
A trap.
This search will only get more dangerous.
Then we keep looking.
Back to the wolves, then.
The wolves have picked up another trail. Keep following their heads.
Mimir, the legends you spoke of are true. The Sisters of Fate abused their power. When I challenged them, they threatened to undo my existence. So I killed them and turned their power on Zeus.
That's the most dangerous and irresponsible thing I've ever heard. These Norns have no such magic, nor does anyone in these realms that I've ever seen.
Ah, can you imagine? If it existed, Odin would have it. And if Odin had it, we'd be five shades more fucked than we are already.
I would not ask them to change the past, even if they could. I only want information.
And that's quite dangerous enough, in my experience.
This is the place. We need to work our way up. This way. Way through the ice?
Oh, are the Norns making magical ice walls now?
No. I think the water just froze.
More of your friends.
I didn't tell them to be here.
Incoming right side!
Another Raider! To the left!
what the Norns did to trick all these raiders into guarding them. Not that they have any idea that's what they're doing.
Freya, thank you for your help. I know this was not your focus.
The sooner we find your son, the sooner you'll be able to focus. I just hope it works.
Just the same. Thank you.
A fine sentiment, but write on a bloody note when we're out of the cold, brother.
Feel something. It's stronger this time. Over here. Open up. We found it.
Ah, isn't it always the third place you look? Is everyone hearing that creepy whisper?
It is like an itch in the mind.
It means we've stepped into their domain. Be ready for anything.
Illusions.
Projections, possibly. But assume nothing. There's no telling what manner of creature they've made unwitting guards.
Delightful.
Kratos. Ghost of Sparta. Kratos, Ghost of Sparta, Bane of Olympus, Destroyer of Fate, Cruel Strike, Bringer of War, Weapon of the Gods, turned against his creators. He chases A redemption he knows he can never deserve. He cannot change.
In our own minds yet. He certainly seemed real enough.
I hate to tell you, the parts in your mind will be real too. Almost looks familiar, but different. Like a confused memory.
Rather hostile memory at that.
These fates should know I will not be deterred.
Freya of the Vanished, Master of Magics. Friend of Asgard, destroyer of all she would hope to protect. She always finds somebody to blame. She cannot change.
Is blood.
Ah, here we go.
Counselor to kings. Merry Wanderer of the Woods. Robin of the Goodfellas.
Let me guess. I'm a long-winded know-it-all, and I cannot change. See? You forgot, smartest man alive. Suppose there's one small consolation to this ordeal. At least we won't have to introduce ourselves.
Don't credit your reputation, Mimir. They see the whole lives of any who approach them.
What is that?
A phantom! Rogue magic! Aim for the runic core!
Bloody hell! Look at that thing! So intimidating without your springs, are you? Well, yet another gift of Fimbulwinter, I suppose.
The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
This way.
The Norns are somewhere in that cave just ahead.
There's that itchy sound again. Normally, I don't mind ladies whispering in my ear, but this is positively irksome.
Anyone ever tell you that you babble when you're terrified?
Terrified? I'll have you know I'm at the very most deeply apprehensive. And breaking tension with humor is the sacred duty of a traveling companion. How very dare you! Babbling!
A door.
Oh, that looks official.
Baldur, come back! Talk to me!
Oh, I want none of this!
Mimmy!
Sigrun? Brother, hold off!
Why did you never turn on Odin?
But I did! I tried to stop him any way I could!
No!
Sigrun, stop!
You stopped Odin from the day you met to the day he put you in that tree! You sought favor! You plotted his war! You watched him mistreat everyone and everything, and you never gave a damn until you turned on.
I know, Sigrun. It's true, all of it. But for love of you, I became a better man, a counselor, an ally to all.
Were you an ally to Freya in his suffering? To Skadi, to Kroll, or to Tanya? No! You all took the side of the powerful men! You!
Brother, watch out! There's more of them!
Even now, you see a crying god in need, and you can't help but aid him and call him brother! It's who you are, and it's who you go.
It is not her.
No, of course. You did what you must.
Brother, the tree, it's pulling me in.
Mimir.
Brother, help me, monster.
Atreus, I am coming.
Why didn't you trust your own son?
Don't let him take me!
Atreus!
I'm scared!
Why wouldn't you see him the way he wants to be seen?
I don't want to do that!
I am here!
Go!
He's a murderer!
That's all I have to do. Now he's mine.
He killed his own family!
Atreus! I am here!
It's over. Did we pass the test?
Didn't feel much like succeeding.
I see the door has disappeared.
Or it was never there.
They toy with us still. What is that?
A Kelpie. Don't see many of those in these parts.
She must be theirs.
Will she take us to them?
I'll ask her. Nicely. Easy, girl. Easy. That's right. Good.
Care to talk about whatever the Norns put you through?
No.
Get on.
That's a good lass. Lovely creatures, but temperamental by reputation. In my land, they'd keep children away from the loch by telling them a Kelpie would drown them. Of course, no Kelpie I know would do such a thing. Unless it was disrespected.
It walks on water.
Aye. No mystical water steeds to speak of in Greece, brother?
There were the hippocamps. They served the sea god. I battled one upon a titan.
That might not be her favorite subject.
Own hideaway. Never doubted we'd make it.
Kratos, Freya, and Mimir's head. Enter the home of the Norns. Tentatively. They have finally reached their destination. Kratos speaks first.
I seek my son!
You know the child is an Asgard. No, you seek what all who search for us seek. To know the ending to your story. The ghost of Sparta furrows his brow menacingly. He resists the urge to grunt. Oh, he fails. You come to us, piteous archetypes, seeking freedom from your scripts. As if knowing your lines would grant you the power to rewrite them.
Speak plain.
You will die, Kratos of Sparta.
But you called him the destroyer of fate. There must be a way to subvert destiny.
There is no destiny, Puck. The protagonists are speechless. They do not understand.
There is no grand design, no script. Only the choices you make. That your choices are so predictable merely make us seem prescient.
When my son was born...
Shut up!
Your prophecy said he would die a needless death.
And he did. Because you could not let him go. Because he thirsted for revenge. And because you kill gods.
But what Kratos did, it was not out of hate.
Should I bring him a crown then? He still slays gods, but now he's sad about it? You are the sum of your choices, nothing more. And because your choices never change, you will learn that Heimdall intends to kill your son in Asgard, and you will do what you do best. And then Ragnarok.
The skies burn, the curtains fall. Exunt omnes.
Heimdall.
Again, he misses the point.
Focusing on the second act to the exclusion of the final. A common mistake in storycraft.
We are leaving.
He stomps away, followed closely by Freya.
I enjoyed your story, Kratos. Pity it has to end so soon.
Well, that was educational.
Let us leave this place.
Happily.
Oh, I'm better. I can feel things getting more normal already.
Wait. That tree.
Well, isn't that interesting?
What is this?
That's the noose, brother. The one Odin hanged himself with. As part of his endless mad quest for secrets of life and death and what have you.
What are you doing?
It's a charged object, significant to Odin. Perhaps I'll find a use for it.
Brother, what they said about the boy...
will not happen.
Oh, I agree.
It will not happen. We will not let it.
Of course we bloody won't. The question is how? You wouldn't seriously consider killing Heimdall, would you?
I will do what I must.
Oh, is that all?
You're wrong to dissuade him.